Football is back here at the Rock Bowl as we welcome you to the Duhawks' first home game of the season, where they will take on the Eagles of Benedictine University in a few short moments. Good evening, and thank you for joining us in the broadcast booth tonight. My name is Ryan Haywood, and joining me once again this year, David Peters. David, so glad to have you back.
It's awesome to be back here calling Warriors Athletics. The Duhawks looking to bounce back from last week's loss to Hope College.
Let's send it down to the third member of our crew, Brock Booth. Brock, happy game day to you.
Yeah, thanks, guys. I'm super excited to be here, but I'm, of course, not the only one that's super excited to be here. The Duhawks fans came out in droves today to support their Duhawks in this first game against Benedictine. I had a chance to talk with some of the guys before the games about the atmosphere and just the general vibes they had going into this one, and all the guys had one common word: electric. They're all super excited for this atmosphere. They're pumped. It's a night game, the only one of the year, and last year was an absolute thriller. They beat Benedictine 42-41. I expect the exact same thing again here today, guys.
Coach Helminiak's 10th season. He's going to be looking to lead the Duhawks back to an ARC victory. Not back to it, I should say, to their first one in quite some time, David.
Oh, yeah. You don't start conference play until next week, so this is a game that just get you ready for that. You know, next week's your first ARC title game, or ARC conference game.
Of course, there it is. The first moments of our game. Of course, the Duhawks very pumped up. Looks like they have won the toss.
Assuming they're getting ball first.
And with that being the case, David, who's on offense to start out for the Duhawks?
So on offense, we have last year's ARC honorable mention, quarterback Evan England. At wide receiver, we have Brock Couch, Jaheim Hayes, Ian Brocious. And on the offensive line, we have Tyson Smith, Caden Griffith, Eli Dutton, Justin Hayes, Caden Carnes. And at tight end, we have Jacob Dedro, and at tailback, Carter Cahill.
And on defense for the Benedictine Eagles, we've got Johnny Camillo, Josh Coates, Walker Zweitzis, Robert Goddard, Jesse Escudero, Jacob Diamantos, Tyler Walker, Brian Pritt, TJ Jones, Jose Berrigan, and Jack Hayden.
Duhawk return team getting ready to go out here.
And following last week, David, it was a very tough game for the Duhawks. It was a 49-0 road loss as the Duhawks marched up to Hope College. Of course, nothing put on the scoreboard there for QB Evan England and company, but what are some of your keys for them today?
So for tonight's game, they need to finish drives. Last week, we saw numerous drives get stalled out and kind of kill any momentum that they could have had. And then we also need to see them control the clock. Last week, they only had the ball for 24 minutes. They need this week to limit the possessions that Benedictine can have. And finally, don't force a deep ball. Benedictine plays a soft zone that allows deep, short passes in front of them. Don't test them over deep. Take the plays you can get.
It's a cloudy day here, but the first night game of the season. Always an electric atmosphere here at the Rock Bowl, and we are now underway for Duhawk football in this 2024 Duhawk campaign. And the Duhawks will start with a few extra yards here.
Good return for Loris. That was down to the 25.
Yeah.
Hard to tell, 24-25.
And that was, of course, Zacchaeus Knighton, the seventh year returner for the Duhawks. Always a pleasure to see him on the field. And we'll see what this first group will do here for the Duhawks. QB Evan England, the first snaps at the Rock Bowl this season. England, they're gonna do a little draw play here for a couple of yards. Looks like it'll be settled at the Eagles 31. Second down.
Yeah, likely gain of four. And if you can get that every time you hand the rock off, the first down every three plays. Use that, drive down the field, keep the ball on the ground. Control that clock.
And, of course, that was running back Carter Cahill there. England's going to draw. He's going to throw it. And a great throw, a great completion Looks like it's first down, and you can move those chains.
Yeah, that was one of the returning players, Jaheim Hayes.
First down here, yet again for the Duhawks. See if they can get another one. There's another run play. I'm liking this early start. Quick statement in this hurry-up offense.
Yeah, and also they're putting in a lot of motions to kind of confuse the defense. Because they do bring up that one defensive back to kind of make it a four-man front, number 22. It's kind of confusing the defense with that.
Senior quarterback going to take a slide there. And Evan, last game, 17 completions on 24 throws. Of course, 71% completion percentage. Totaled 108 yards, but nothing to show for it on the scoreboard.
No, and you're hoping to change that this week, especially before you start conference play next week.
A couple of defensive substitutions on the field for the Eagles. Third down, they're going to look to throw it. Evan England is going to find a man and a good tackle, but an also equally good throw.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, throwing out outside of the numbers is going to be a big piece of today's game.
So it looks like the offense will come out. And we'll have special teams come up here for the Duhawks.
Yeah, today's punter is Dan Gisto.
Yes, Dan is a sophomore, a new face around here.
Mm-hmm.
The 6'2", 185 sophomore from Mokena, Illinois.
A lot of new faces for the Forest team this year.
The punt is up and good. And they'll signal a fair catch around the 10-yard line for the Eagles. Now the Eagles, it's a dual quarterback threat. Evan Wydajewski, some of our friends have said he looks like Patrick Mahomes. I know the Hope broadcasters last week mentioned he was having some shades of Patrick Mahomes in his game. What do you like about his game?
Evan, just he's a dual threat QB. He can make you pay on the run if you don't test him. If you don't, you know, if you leave him space, he'll break you on the run.
And again, last week they played the Buena Vista Beavers. Evan, 20 for 28, a very impressive game. Of course, two interceptions, not the greatest, but four touchdowns and 257 total yards.
Yeah, you know, as long as you get the win stats really aren't as important. You know, four touchdowns, that's play of the game.
That right there is running back Blake Shoddy on the side, and he's... Looks like he is out of bounds around the 45, but what a run for Shoddy, the 5'5", 200 senior.
Yeah, that's what you want to avoid. You want to avoid the Eagles offensive line, setting the edge and long big runs to the outside like that.
Out of bounds at the 46-yard. A big first down run here to kind of quiet this crowd down. Offense looks like they're getting ready. It's going to be another run play for the Eagles and another first down.
Yeah, similar play that just ran play before.
The run game looks like it's certainly going to be a big, big part of this game today.
Yeah, Benedictine likes that outside zone run.
David, who do we have on the Duhawk defense out?
So for the Duhawk defense, you have Preston Perchusik, Emmett Finn, Max Turlap, Andrew Hafel, Nico Emilio, Henry Ivers, Brendan Phelps, Zacchaeus Knighton, Cormaic Flynn, Owen Kelly, and Brandon Glover.
Eagles making quick work so far on their first drive. There's Wydajewski, and the ball is going to go right behind him. A little error there, and it looks like he's on top of it.
That ball slipped out of his hand.
That was quite an interesting move there. He just kind of dropped back, and you know, a little butterfinger there.
Kind of surprised he didn't call that an incomplete pass with his arm going forward. They are kind of communicating right here.
Yeah, let's see what the
hold on the offense.
Whoa.
So they called a hold on the offense, but it was declined. So the Duhawks are taking the penalty yardage, or not taking the penalty yardage, taking the sack offense, yardage.
Number 52. That penalty's a second down.
I did not see a flag thrown out there.
I didn't either, but they've got better eyes down there than we do up here. Second and long for the Eagles. Wojciechowski's going to hand it off yet again, and the run game working pretty decent there. A nice pickup of about 6 or 7 yards.
Yeah, they're going to continue to use this run game until it doesn't work anymore. That's what they did last week. You saw Shoddy have, you know, 30 carries, 35 carries last week.
Yeah, he'll be a big factor, but running there with the rock was Braden Tranel, a freshman for the Eagles. He walked off. Substitution, we see Shoddy in the backfield now.
Yeah, they rotate their running backs quite a bit.
They had third down here, David. Let's see it. Wojciechowski is going to throw it open, and looks like there's no flag, no penalty on the play. It'll be fourth down. Great coverage there, and it looked like that was number 11 on the Eagles. Kind of just tripped a little bit.
Yeah, just fell over his feet, kind of coming up on that crossing route.
Tough luck there on the throw.
Yeah, that was looking to be a nice drive for them, kind of stalled out on that. Are they going for it?
Oh, my goodness. Yeah, it looks like they're going to go for it.
Oh, they're doing that. Pooch punt.
Oh. Ow. Had me fooled for a little bit.
Me too.
Ball will bounce out of bounds, and the Duhawks will take over on three and out.
Some nice punts early on. A lot of hang time. And
yeah, with the weather being as humid as it is out here, of course, we might see the ball hang a little bit more normal. More than normal, I should say. And we'll see the second attempt for this Duhawk offense. Carter Cahill in the backfield. Receiver motion wide. He's going to throw to Cahill, and a nice tackle made there. And it looks like, did the ball come loose?
No, they're calling it incomplete. I don't think he made a football move to secure the catch.
Good eyes there, David.
From what I saw, he had the ball kind of trapped at the bottom of his palms. Good break there for Loris.
Quite the break. Perhaps some early jitters here for both teams.
Mm-hmm.
We'll see if they can make work of it again. Here on second down, England. He's going to look left. But he's taken down. And I do believe that's going to be credited to Brian Pritt for the Eagles on a sack.
Yeah, the interior of the O-line kind of came in. And, you know, he had nowhere to go.
Tyler Walker, the linebacker for the Eagles, going to take credit for that.
Yeah, it's likely, you know, this is where both teams have their scripts made for the first few drives of the game, kind of to see what they can work out early on.
Third and 17, another draw play. Not much yardage there, and we'll see another fourth down. David, what do you think is on the mind of Coach Helminiak, you know, drawing some of these plays up here early?
Just kind of seeing what you can exploit of this Eagles defense. Is it the short, quick pass game? Is it the run game outside or inside? Or is it maybe occasional deep pass? Like I said, they do play that soft zone where it leaves you some cushion to throw short routes. You've kind of seen it early on so far.
So the punt team is out here for the Duhawks. We'll see Justo give it a good kick. And it's out of the hands. It is bobbled. And it looks like the Duhawks have recovered the football.
Is that the official yet?
And it is. What a recovery for the Duhawks.
Yeah, that right there, that's something that your coach would be upset with if you're Benedictine. You let that ball go out of bounds, even if it takes a bad bounce. These plays like that are happening. They can handicap you early on.
Henry Ivers, the linebacker there on special teams, quickly got out onto that ball. We will see the DuHawks try again. What a fortunate thing there for the DuHawks. We do have a man down for the Eagles.
Yeah, plays can be made on special teams. You know, games can be won right there, and this could be a play that defines what happens up next.
Special teams, special plays, special players here for the DuHawks and Henry Ivers.
Absolutely.
Of course, we do hope that this Eagles player is okay.
Absolutely. It's sad to see injuries happen.
Now, we do know that the run game is going to be big here for both teams, but for this offensive line to try and help protect Evan England, what adjustments do they have to make, David, in order to kind of help contain him, see less sacks in the stat book?
So understand where he's at, and that's a hard thing to understand, but you got to have that presence of where he's at in the pocket, because that'll help you, because if he's not where you think he is, it can lead up to sacks and cause issues, especially on the blind side.
8:25 left here in the first quarter. Of course, we are just getting started in this young DuHawk season. England throws it to his left, and a good tackle made there on defense for the Eagles.
Yeah, so far neither team has really tested the middle of the field yet. It's all been outside to the field or boundary side of the field.
And here's what I've been talking about, this hurry-up offense for the DuHawks. Here's a nice run here for Cahill. There's a flag being called.
Block in the back, I would assume. I think I saw that. Or hold.
We'll see what the refs call it here.
Based on where the flag was at, I would assume it's coming back.
Yeah, certainly looks like it. The DuHawk offense moving back.
Yeah, I saw the offensive lineman kind of get caught up.
But that was a great run there for Cahill.
Oh, yeah.
Caden Carnes, the right tackle for the DuHawks.
Yeah, he avoided that ankle tackle, which you see a lot of running backs get tripped up on.
Looks like we'll see Cahill being taken out. It'll be, looks like, four wide receivers and a tight end here for the DuHawks. No run play that we can assume. Second and long for England. England, he's going to run it himself. He's got quite the legs on him, as we have seen before. The ball is out and recovered by the Eagles.
That was miscues like that can't happen for either team, and kind of even now.
Johnny Camillo, the 5'10", fifth year for the Eagles, coming up with that play. And we've seen a couple of exchanges here now.
Oh, yeah.
Like, this is incredible to see here. .743 as we have a change of sides here for both teams. And we'll get another chance to look at Evan Wydajewski. First and 10 for Blake Shoddy. He's going to run it on the outside, and will be a gain of a few yards.
Yeah, they're punching at the ball. Kind of can see the peanut punch. Yeah, they're trying to get that ball out.
Shoddy with quite the presence here for the Eagles so far. A couple of impressive runs. And we'll take a look at second down on the 40.
Would assume some sort of pass with trips left.
Motioned back here. Blake Shoddy's going to be given the ball, and he's just going to keep bouncing off for a run. And he keeps going. Oh, my goodness. Blake Shoddy, and now he is taken down. at what appears to be the 7-yard line. Oh my, shoddy.
Yeah, we're making fun of that touchdown saving tackle. They're watching Derrick Henry run.
Here's the replay. We've got it here. And broke up quite a few tackles. You saw him tiptoe a little bit.
Yeah, you see Cormac Flynn come in, you know, from the other side of the field. Tries to knock that ball out as he's tackling him, too.
But the chain gang is glad that they don't have to keep track here. It's first and goal for the Eagles. Another run play and stopped short of the goal line.
Javier Acosta with the carry. Yeah, Javier Acosta just, he's a nice third down back to do kind of what they use him for, short field.
See a couple of substitutions here for the Eagles.
Yeah, Benedictine has a nice RB group. Yeah, your lead back of Blake Shoddy, and you have Javier Acosta, who before he transferred was a 500-yard rusher.
We'll see what the Eagles do here. Looks like it's second and one on the one. It's a run play. We have flags immediately.
Offside?
It looks like it could have been offsides, David.
You love to see that little flex bone offense.
It does appear that the ball perhaps made it over on the goal line. We'll hear from the officials. It has stopped short.
Could be legal formation.
Offside, defense,
number 95. Half distance goal. So the Dewhawks have another chance to try and stop this Eagle artillery.
I believe he was stopped short, too.
Yeah.
Nice little goal line stand in that first down play or second down play.
It does appear to be a second and short, of course, with that penalty. In formation, and the run is good for the Benedictine Eagles. They are first on the scoreboard, and that is our guy. We've been talking about him so far, Blake Shoddy.
That is a little draw play out of Wishbone. And like me and my play CFB 25. Same offense.
And they'll try for an extra point here. Looks like we got another player running on for the Eagles. Another two? Or is one coming off?
Well,
they better figure it out quick.
Yeah, they have until the play clock ends.
Looks like we do have another flag.
Play a game. Play a clock ran out.
Play a game on the offense. Number 52. Five yard penalty. You try.
And Humberto Velazquez, the 5'11 freshman for the Eagles. They're going to try and go for it here.
22 yards.
It is up and it is in. Quick 7-0 here for the Eagles. 5:09 left in this first quarter. David, your thoughts on that drive?
Yeah, they kind of attacked the ground again. Something you saw that first drive when they had the ball is that run game needs to be stopped. It's their biggest playmaker. And you saw why Shoddy is, you know, as good as he is because he can break those tackles. Just doesn't stop running.
He does not, no. Shades of Derrick Henry out there, mm-hmm. Would you say?
Oh, absolutely. Kind of made that comparison earlier. That low center of gravity where you can just kind of run through guys and break as many tackles. Very rarely do you get that kind of running back who can, you know, doesn't need it, you know, who can stay straight up and still run through.
And of course, this is a Benedictine squad that's come off a 34-7 victory in Storm Lake last week, of course, playing the Buena Vista University Beavers. So they are a team not to be reckoned with so far in this young season.
A They relied heavy on that passing game last week, but this week seems very different so far.
Very much so. Kind of surprising early on. Of course, we've got the rest of the game, but Blake Shotty definitely doing his part.
Morris has a veteran secondary that can, you know, limit the passes too.
And here is Velasquez again with a boot. The Duhawks are going to try and run it back for quite a few yards and be taken down near the 20.
Yeah, about 5 yards short of where a touchback would have been.
Definitely. And especially with this Duhawk offense coming back out, we have seen them the last couple of drives, a couple of errors. Of course, they've got time to try and flip the script here. So we'll see what they can do here on first and 10 on the 18. Haynes motions to the right, and it'll be a run play for the Duhawks. And a nice gain of about 5 yards for Cahill.
Yeah, he's been getting a lot of yards each play. Pretty high yards per carry, which is nice to see.
Very reliable early.
Something you may see is the guy still looking over, you know, getting the signals. The NCAA did pass the Connor Salyans rule, which is allowing headsets in games, but the ARC does not have that this year.
England being chased by a couple of Eagles. He's just going to throw it away, and it looks like it was an incomplete pass to, looks like, Carter Cahill.
Yeah, when you watch Evan England play, he is kind of like an improviser quarterback where he runs to extend plays. He doesn't always run to make the plays. It's always kind of, he runs to throw, not runs to run.
But he can certainly do that.
Oh,
he's got that capability. We have seen that one run here earlier today.
Oh, absolutely. But he's not like a run-first QB. Which isn't like...
Third and six on the 22. England's going to throw. He finds a man, and first down for the Duhawks. That was completed to Jaheim Hayes.
He's brought down at the 32. That's a Wells College first down.
Hey, Hayes with his first crack as wide receiver one for the Duhawks.
England's going to find Cahill. Cahill going to try and bulldoze his way in. He's going to have some help from the Duhawks. He's finally taken down. A nice push by wide receiver Brock Couch. Try and keep some extra yards.
Yeah,
for the Duhawks.
Cahill is like an all-around back. He can play out the, you know, play in the run and play and catch out the backfield.
See a quick substitution.
Stops at the 34, second down.
Kind of has a Christian McCaffrey placed out of him.
Looks like it here. It was Hunter Guyon that came in for Jacob Tidro. On the Duhawks, second down. Here's England. A fake run and the throw. It is good. And there's Brock Couch.
England's pass is caught by Brock Couch.
We see another first down. Very promising throws here for the Duhawks. They keep marching down. Keep fighting the good fight on short pass.
Yeah, nothing has really changed from their first two drives. Still targeting outside the numbers on throws.
Here's the first down. Cahill gets bottled up here, and it looks like, did the ball come loose? We'll find out here shortly. And recovered by the Eagles on that play. And what is going on here with the Duhawks? This is the...
See, Loris is holding the ball loose. You couldn't tell on Jaheim Hayes' catch, too. He's kind of the same way.
And to your credit, and you pointed it out earlier, you got to hold on to the ball. You cannot leave the ball out from your body. You got to bring it in.
These are the kind of plays that can win or lose you a game.
What should have been first and 10 for the Duhawks is now first and 10 on the 47 for the Eagles. Wide Ajewski under center right next to his trusted partner, Blake Shotty, who has got the ball, and he's going to keep running. and a nice cut tackle made on defense for the Hawks.
Yeah, Loris's defensive line, they're getting a nice push at the, set, you know, at the line of scrimmage.
That was number 36, Brandon Phelps, 5'11 senior.
Loris kind of runs a 3-4 defense, as you can tell. Brings both their outside backers off the edge.
Got quite a few receivers out wide. Wojciechowski's going to look in, and an incomplete pass. And that was supposed to go to number 19, Hunley Stallings, 6'2 senior halfback.
Yeah, he was their leading receiver last week with 50-plus yards.
Very impressive for a halfback, David.
Mm-hmm.
They'll try it again here. 3rd and 9 on the 46. 2:08 on the clock for the first quarter.
Yeah, Benedictine's offense kind of revolves all around the running back, we've seen so far today.
Wojciechowski's going to find a man down and incomplete. Duhawks secondary coming up clutch. That was again intended for Stallings. And Owen Kelly making a fantastic move to keep in check this Eagles offense. And it looks like it'll be special teams coming out here for the Eagles.
The thing I noticed on that play, too, is as the Duhawk edge rushers are coming in, Wojciechowski stayed calm and delivered a nice ball. That's nice to see to his credit.
Looked like it was a little underthrown, maybe a little higher than he anticipated. Mm-hmm. And the punt, a little short here. It'll take a very friendly Eagle bounce to around the 3-yard line. And it keeps going. It'll stop at the 2. For the Eagles, that's exactly what you want here.
Yeah, Stallings is their punter too. I just realized that.
He's doing everything that he can the last couple drives here for Eagles.
Yeah, in college you see that those pooch punts a lot. It makes it a lot harder for the defense to kind of know what you're doing until you start and you send the motion.
We have seen quite a few drives here early for this Duhawk offense. They have been in this position before. We'll see if they can crawl their way out of it.
It's all about staying composed in this spot of the field.
Of course, very hard when you're in your own zone. And a gain of a few. Did the
ball came out again?
Well, they held on to the ball this time. We've got a couple of substitutions for both teams. Again, Cahill coming out.
Spot of the ball is the 4-yard line, second down.
If my eyes don't deceive me, that's Zacchaeus Knighton in the backfield. Evan is going to throw it. Nice throw to Hayes.
Impressive catch by Hayes right there.
Very much. He had to adjust late just to come up with it. It'll be 3rd and 4 on the 7-yard line for the Duhawks.
It's hard for receivers to brace for those hits as well as trying to keep control of the ball.
Seconds and counting down for the Duhawks. And the ball is battered down, and Evan's going to come up with it. It'll be 4th down yet again for the Duhawks.
Good heads up play by Evan, too, to stay, play for that ball. They very well could have went the other way with the defensive player right there.
Clock continuing to tick down here. In this first quarter at the Rock Bowl. See if the punt team will be able to get it out, but they will not be able to.
That's the end of the first quarter.
And the second quarter will begin in a few moments. But, David, your thoughts early on this game. Of course, for this Duhok offense, not being able to get a lot done, but a couple of positive notes to take away.
Yeah, the passing game is working very nicely. You know, everything is staying short, which is kind of what you want to keep. And they're gaining nice yardage off of it, but it all starts in the trenches. If the O-line can hold their own on both runs and passing plays, plays will be made. And kind of what you've seen on, you know, defensively, too, is that they're kind of winning at the center of attack. They're pressuring the QB. They're at least getting in there.
Let's take a look at some of these stats here. In the first quarter, we have 9 rushing attempts for Benedictine, which doesn't seem like a lot, but when you think about what they've been able to do with the run game, it's been very impactful.
Yeah, Blake Shoddy has 6 rushes for 105 yards.
Oh, my goodness.
He's on pace for 420 rushing yards in this game.
Would be quite the game here at the Rock Bowl if that happened.
Yeah, but, you know, to their credit, Evan Wojciechowski is over 3 so far.
Not much in the throw, but it's about what you can get done here, no matter how you get it done. As long as you can hang some points up on the scoreboard, we'll see the punt team try and punt it away. And taking a couple of bounces out, and we'll stop at the 40-yard line. Again, in the first quarter, Benedictine averaging 8.5 yards per play, while the Duhawks with a measly 1.28 yards.
Yeah, a lot of it comes from those negative plays. You know, the sacks and negative rushing yards.
And we'll see Evan Wojciechowski yet again. Going the opposite way, of course. Got all the time in the world. Try and plan this out. Here we go on 1st and 10 for the Eagles.
Yeah, they have a bunch to the right.
And they're going to run it up the gut. And a couple of yards on that run play, we'll see 2nd down.
Yeah, that's the 4th running back we've seen in for Benedictine so far.
You get a rush. It's like being on the Oprah Winfrey show.
Absolutely. Well, good offenses do that. They rotate their guys.
It's a sign of a great offense. We'll see what they can do here against this Duhok secondary. 2nd and 8 on the 39.
Benedictine stayed in the shotgun the entire game outside their two goal line plays.
Wojciechowski's going to hand it off, and not easily going down are the Eagles. And that was quite the run again.
Yeah, Zacchaeus Knight kind of over pursued on that play. He was in nice range to kind of cut off the running back.
3rd and 3 on the 34. Duhok's looking for a big stop here, try and get some momentum going in their favor.
Yeah, the Rock Bowl's getting loud here on 3rd down.
We love to see the Rock Bowl rocking early in the season.
Oh, absolutely.
Wojciechowski calling for a timeout. And the Eagles will talk it over.
The stadium pulse might be super high right now.
It might be for head coach Jim Schroeder and the Eagles. We'll see.
Here's some AC/DC in the background.
It's always a good stopper here at the Rock Bowl.
Of course.
Carter Cahill, 23 yard gains in that first quarter. Hopefully, we can see more of that as we go along here, but first they gotta start getting the ball back on defense.
Yeah. And right here, if you're the Loris defense, you kind of want to sell out towards the run because you know that's kind of what's beating you so far. And on 3rd and short, that's most likely what they're going back to.
We'll start it back up on third down. 13:20 left on our clock for this quarter. Wydajewski, he looks right. He's got a man open. That's Stallings. Stallings going to keep going to the 20, the 15, the 10, and he is finally taken out of bounds. A fantastic play drawn up for Coach Schroeder and the Eagles. Boy, I bet they're glad that they took that timeout.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, the Warriors defense bit on both the play action and the motion that they sent. We also overloaded the left side of the field with that wing back.
Speaking of the left side of the field, you can see a wide receiver, Winston Brown, in 6'1 senior for the Eagles. Keep an eye on him. Wydajewski is going to hand it off and stopped for a loss on first down. It would be second and long.
You notice those kind of gang tackles right there by the defense. It avoids the, you know, one-on-one tackles. Less chance for Shoddy to break the tackle. Yeah, Benedict can also use a lot of this play clock. They'll bring it down to 10 seconds under every single time.
Second and 12 on the 12, and the handoff worked pretty good there. Almost got to the end zone. And we'll see a third and 4 on the 4. Blake Shoddy, again, just a cannonball up the gut. It was quite the run here.
Yeah, the Eagles O-line just parred the Red Seas.
That they did. They're going to try and do that again here. Looks like some communications between the Eagles offense and their sideline. And Wydajewski, it looks like there's going to be a timeout made by Coach Schroeder. Wydajewski looked a little flustered by that call. I think he was ready to go with something, but there was something that Coach Schroeder saw on that on the Duhawk secondary.
Yeah, you could see the guys on the sideline making signals to the offense. It's hard to tell who's, you know, their signal guy, because, you know, they're all doing different ones.
And what does it say, David, about a coach trying to make those quick adjustments early on and the trust dynamic between a coach and a player like Evan Wydajewski?
You have to have a lot of trust in your quarterback to understand and, you know, go to the line and check out of something. A lot of QBs in college don't get that trust in the quarterbacks unless they understand who you are as a player.
And again, we'll come back. It's third and 4 on the 4. Shoddy in the backfield. Wydajewski motioning Stallings to come to his right. Just a little bit. Shoddy with the ball. No, he doesn't. And the throw is good for Evan Wydajewski. And another great change there for Coach Schroeder and the Eagles.
Yeah, they're exploiting the mismatch on that Loris defense. They're just bringing the wing, they're bringing the receiver into a wing across the field after the ball snapped. Just into the flat, and it's worked both times.
And he's got another look there. That was Hunley Stallings once again making plays here. And here's another look at Humberto Velasquez. The kick is up, and it is good. And 14-0 hangs on the board here at the Rock Bowl.
If you're the Duhawks, you want to keep your spirits higher here. So it's only 14 points, it's two scores. You're still in this game.
Yeah, certainly very early here. But that 3-yard touchdown's got to take the wind out of your sails, so to speak. Perhaps a little early, but the Duhawks will have another chance to try and correct that again.
Yeah, still a lot of time left in this one.
Plenty of time, and speaking of time, 11:17 on the board. Here's another look at that touchdown for all you viewers.
Yeah, they just motioned Stallings into the into the wingback position, brought him into the flat once the ball was snapped, and everybody bit on it.
But the coverage seemed quite shallow. It didn't seem like the secondary picked up on that at all.
Yeah, they were beating that same play two plays prior.
While we wait for the kickoff to happen, let's take a look at some of the action going around the ARC for football. Wartburg was away against St. John's, but a very, very unfamiliar loss for them against St. John's, 35-13 in Minnesota.
Yeah, they fought 1-1 after the first two games of the year, beating Monmouth last week.
And they're a team that certainly looks like could compete for a title in this ARC. Still plenty of time to tell. And here's the kickoff from Velasquez, and it's going to go out of bounds for the Duhawks.
Yeah, very competitive ARC conference this year.
Very much so, and take a look at other scores around the league. Nebraska Wesleyan hung 34 on Mayville State, 34-24 victory for them. Co, 43-41 victory in overtime. Very exciting match against New Clare. Buena Vista losing to Wisconsin Lutheran 44-13. And St. Olaf, how about this? 53-7 on Luther. St. Olaf with that victory.
Wow. Highest scoring in the fair out of that one. 60 points.
Very much so. Of course, tonight Simpson is playing in Indianola, taking on Crown, and University of Dubuque taking on Wisconsin Platteville. And we'll check on those scores as they become available. But for now, back on the field, will be a flag on the play. Looks like it could be in sportsmanlike conduct.
It'll either be unsportsmanlike or unnecessary roughness, depending on what the refs deem it as. And in college, two unsportsmanlike conducts get you thrown out of the game.
It does. Definitely does. And David, we have seen across Division I, Division II, and Division III athletics, we have seen a whole host of changes going on. What are some of the big changes that are noteworthy to you?
So as I mentioned earlier,
let's get a replay of that here if we can. David, we'll come back to your thoughts on some of those changes, but let's take a look here. What do we see?
Yeah, the Eagles D-line kind of ganged up on the running back.
And it looked like
post play.
Oh, interesting call there.
The refs have the better view than us.
They do, but it did look like, though, the linebacker, Tyler Walker, number zero, the fifth-year senior, it looked like he just kind of shoved.
Yeah, that's what I saw, but
it was a shoving type of play, and
it's a weird play overall.
Yeah. I think that's something, the chippiness factor, of course, as we go along here in this game. We'll keep an eye on that. But, David, going back to noteworthy changes around college football, what were some things of note for you?
Yeah, so as I mentioned earlier, the counter stealing rule was implemented this year following whatever happened with sign stealing last year. And so across all three divisions, you can use headset communication, and in Division III, it's a conference-by-conference basis. This year, the ARC is not having that. And another thing we saw added this year is a two-minute timeout.
So correct me if I'm wrong. Sorry to cut you off, but so it's no longer a two-minute warning in the fourth quarter. It'll be a two-minute timeout.
Yeah, so in the NFL, you have a two-minute warning. In college, you implement a two-minute timeout. I'm not sure of the name change or why they're calling a two-minute timeout this year. And with that, the clock only stops on first downs in the end of the first, end of the two minutes in both halves. So other than that, before the 2 minutes and last minute of each half, clock will keep running after a first down.
So a couple of plays that you saw there on your screen on second down was a tipped pass to Hayes, of course, and then of course on third down, Cahill with the run. Again, short of the first down marker by quite a bit. Now it's 4th and 18 on the 19. We'll see Another punt here by Giusto. He's seen a lot of action. The ball drops around the 50-yard line.
Yeah, that penalty changed things. It sent them back about 5 yards, about 10 yards from where they originally were. And if you flip that to the other side, it's, you know, 15 yards against the defense.
With the punt for Morris, down to the 45-yard line, first down for the Eagles.
So not a whole lot going right on the offensive side for the Duhawks. What are some things, let's say you're Coach Helminiak, David. Mm-hmm. What are some of the moves you're looking at changing when talking to the guys as they're coming off the field?
I would say kind of just keeping your head up and knowing that this game's not over. You're not even at halftime yet. You still have 11 minutes to go here in this first half. And it's about, you know, seeing what's going wrong so far and changing that. Easier said than done, but it's football. Things change quickly.
Definitely. And we'll see why Dejewski take another crack at the end zone here.
Hey, yeah, so why Dejewski check to a different play right there.
Here's Shoddy again, and it's kind of a meatball for that line.
Okay, one thing I've noticed is Benedictine, their QB uses the cadence, while Loris uses a traditional college clap for their cadence.
Second down at the 47.
It really changes things too, especially with the crowd gets louder and you can't really hear.
Second and 8 on the 47. 9:32 left to go in this one.
Warriors.
For the second half, or second quarter, of course. Wydajewski's going to throw right, and nice grab there for the Eagles. Looked like to me that it was perhaps hit the ground.
That's what I thought, too. I thought it was going to hit the ground.
Pass complete to Alex
Corbett. Nice little screen play as he got the receivers out there blocking.
Yeah, that's our first look at Alex Corbett, the 5'10 senior wide receiver for this Eagles team. We'll see third and 5 on the 50. Big play here for the Duhawk defense. If they can get a stop, that is.
Nobody deep for the Duhawk defense.
Wydajewski, he's going to find and... Window closed there for the Eagles and almost intercepted for the Duhawks.
Yeah, that's a house call if you can hit that ball through the defense. That's one of those game-changing plays.
It looked like that was Michael Kearney for the Duhawks. We'll get a look at that replay here shortly. And Wydajewski, I mean, great awareness to find the receiver first, but of course the receiver stopped. Of course, not making much of an adjustment to get to the ball.
Yeah, it looks like Drew Dyers tipped that ball once it came out of Wydajewski's hands.
And the punt team comes out, and it's quite a short punt. Of course, it goes way onto the track. Duhawk fans here are going to take it.
That's where the lost fat punt went.
Signs of life here, David.
Yeah, defense kind of held their own there, which is what you want to see.
Out of bounds at the 38, and that's where Loris will take over, first and 10.
Yeah, if you're Loris, you want the interception, but this is the second best scenario out of that drive. You get the ball back with 10 minutes left for your offense.
.839 in the second quarter. 14-0. Benedictine leads so far. England. He's going to look deep, and he's going to launch it. Is it on target? It is not. And that was intended there, again, for Brock Couch.
Yeah, he just led him a couple yards, and if it was on the money, that's a touchdown right there.
And one thing we haven't addressed so far in this game is the absence of Damani Brown. Of course, not in this on this Duhawk team.
Mm-hmm.
Of course, transferring schools, we do wish him the best. But it does mean someone like, let's say, Brock Couch comes in and starts to show us what they're capable of doing.
Yeah, that's the thing with college football. You have a lot of roster turnover each year.
That was a quick, short throw for first down for the Duhawks.
And each year you kind of see a new guy take over that big play ability.
It'll be first and 10 on the Duke Hawk 45. Of course, we're approaching 8 minutes to go. The offense showing signs of life. England. He's going to look to his right, and a circus catch for wow. the Duhawks. Oh, my goodness. Jimmy Peterson, the one set this. My goodness. What in the world, David?
I thought that was overthrown. I thought if he got hit, that was going to be caught.
Wow.
What a play. Those are the kind of plays that, if you're at the Duhawks, you'd love to see.
Cahill with the run there. And we haven't talked about Jimmy Peterson yet. Sophomore, of course, here, 6'170". He's able to bring the ball in midair, something not a lot of receivers are able to do. Show kind of shades of Damani Brown there.
Oh, absolutely. And those kind of plays, they don't need help for getting the ball down the field. It helps, for guys on the field and on the sidelines be more excited, more amped up. This is how crazy those plays are.
We'll see Brock Couch come in for Peterson. Of course, he's there on the bottom right side of your screen. Team in huddle. Looks like they're ready. And we've got a call here for the... for the officials,
what's
the
time?
Did they get that off before the handoff?
I don't know if it was a timeout called or what. It was a
timeout call.
Okay, that solves the mystery there. Here, sideline timeout for the Duhawks.
Yeah, I didn't see a timeout signaled for it first.
Of course, it looks like that's offensive coordinator Jake Olson talking to his men on mm-hmm. the field.
Yeah, this is a nice drive here for Loris. Getting lucky with the field position we're giving off that short punt. That's second and about 7.
So we'll do it again, as David just mentioned, 2nd and 7 on the Duhawk 31.
Yeah, they have 4 guys on that right side of that field.
Definitely an area to keep your eyes on. England's going to hand the ball off to Cahill. Cahill's got a great run. We've got a flag in the backfield. Not quite sure what it is. It looks like a first down for Cahill.
The blocking from the tight end on that play was nice. That's kind of what opened up that hole.
And Duhawk offense going to march down. That's right tackle Caden Carnes. And again, let's take a look at that again, David.
Yeah, you can see the hold right there. Kind of tugs on the inside of his jersey.
Yeah, can't do that.
When I do that, keep your hand open. Go off for one too many of those myself.
Second down yet again. This time 17 to the sticks. Here's England. He's got a scramble and looking outside to the left. And a very late hit. The sideline wants a call for that. They're not going to get it. We'll see third down and just over 10.
So it's been similar last week against Hope. We're having to take a big shot and took his helmet off.
Third and 15 on the 39-yard line.
Now the pocket awareness from Evan is so impressive.
It is, and I mean, he's got that dual threat aspect to his game. Mm-hmm. He can throw it, he can take it if he needs. He's got it all.
He's a Josh Allen kind of player.
Certainly so. Certainly so.
Can totally run when you need him to, but can definitely make plays in the air.
They're going to try and get some positive yards here. England's going to look to his right. He runs out. He's got to run back to his left. He's going to throw out of bounds. Yes. And a fourth down play here once again.
Yeah, that's the right move to make, throwing the ball. You also have to be aware of where you are at when you throw the ball away. Because if you're inside the tackle box or you don't get the line of scrimmage, that's intentional grounding. That's a loss for down.
see special teams come on and the offense coming off for the Duhawks. Very promising drive there up until, of course, the last couple of plays there. But again, what's killing the Duhawks here and stopping the momentum are penalties.
Yeah, you see for both sides. They both, you know, have promising drives that just stall out either negative plays or penalties. A flag was thrown right there.
Lots of flags.
Is it
so far?
Is it on the returner?
It looks like the returner's getting a little talking to by the official downfield.
Yeah, if you're the Warriors, you would rather that penalty be accepted because it gives you more room for that pawn.
But they got to make do with what they've got right now, which is another punt.
And yeah, Lawrence runs that shield punt you see a lot in college and high school.
And here's Justo once again. And pretty solid punt. Does go out of bounds. But again, Duhawk offense coming up just short.
That's an amazing punt right there.
And we welcome you back into the booth, everybody. It is such a beautiful night. It is so great to be calling games once again here in the Rock Bowl. And, of course, I mean, it's just a great atmosphere.
Well, of course.
On the campus, of course, of Loras College. Great to be back with you all.
Yeah, it's a great environment for a game.
And it's beautiful. It's 77 degrees here in Dubuque. 5 minutes and change left to go before halftime.
We'll be under center again.
Interesting play here. They're going to give it off to Shoddy. Shoddy's going to go to his right. Pickup of perhaps a couple yards. Second and 8 on the 4-yard line. Looks like they're trying to kill some time.
Shoddy essentially called an audible when he's with the ball. He kind of bounced out from where he was supposed to go because that was not open.
...17 seconds left on the play clock. Wydajewski is going to look for Shoddy, and he is brought down in the end zone! David, put your hands up!
He got his safety.
Put your hands up, the Buke! What a play, and 2 comes on the board for the Duhawks.
Brandon Phelps comes in, just blows him up. What a play for the defense. Man, you have a Scorigami right here.
Yeah, Scorigami going, that's for sure. But it's good to see that, right? You want to see that 0 come off the board for you if you're Coach Helminiak and the Duhawks. It's nice to finally get something to hang your hat on a little.
Yeah, it does a lot for you once you see points put on the board by your team. The defense has really adjusted well to this Eagles offense following those first few drives.
We are stopped here for both teams to try and get adjustments. David, let's run through some of the stats here, of course, for both squads so far in the second quarter. Again, a lot of it has been flags and stoppages in play. I mean, what's going on in the minds of both coaches so far?
Yeah, so both teams have really been very similar to the second quarter. Loras is averaging more yards per play. But if you're Coach Helminiak, you're you know, starting a little bit more amped up. Your defense is getting stops. Your offense is moving the ball down the field. Although you're not scoring points on offense, you're getting the ball down the field, which is a start.
But the numbers very similar so far. Both squads have two first downs. The Duhawks with 19 rushing yards. It's three more than what the Eagles have. Quite impressive.
Yeah.
And, of course, receiving yards, 25, Loris, 26, Benedictine, as Evan England finds Jaheim Hayes. And he's got a first down.
A toe tap. College only needs 1 foot down.
Yeah, opposed to the NFL, I'm sure many of you viewers are aware of the two-foot rule. Very different here in college. The night sky getting a little brighter as the sun's going down. In Dubuque. First down drive bottled up by the defensive line for the Eagles. We'll see second and seven on the 47. Approaching 3.5 minutes left.
Yeah, Loris hasn't really gotten the run game going as much as they would like.
Well, they certainly tried to listen to you here, and it was only a matter of a couple of yards gained.
Mm-hmm.
We'll see third, and it looks like third and six on the 46.
Gain of one to the 46. Third down.
Another third down. Third down conversion. Not really their thing tonight. It's incredible to see so far, and I'm sure that's going to be a big impact. Of course, impact point for the Duhawks as they go into half.
Absolutely.
We'll see what they can do here on third down. England, he's going to throw it out. And almost caught there.
Oh, that was just through his hands.
Brock Couch almost brought it in. That was great coverage there for the Eagles. And we'll see another fourth down. Again, a nice throw downfield to Couch. He just couldn't bring it in. Wonder if sometimes in these night games, you kind of lose sight of the ball depending on where you're at on the field.
It's also tough to see when you have two guys covering like that. It's hard to see the ball and make plays.
We'll see Justo here with yet again another punt.
I don't know if you've noticed so far, but Benedictine doesn't really rush the punt.
Like they really don't. Have. No.
They bring most of their guys back.
Which is impressive, and why might they do that?
I don't know. It's a rare thing you see. Maybe it's more set up, more blockers. You don't see it often. You'll send five or six guys, you know, at the punter. But it makes Gusto's job a lot easier.
Here we go, first and 10 on the 17 for Benedictine. No motion. Wydajewski's gonna hand it off, and the run game continues. Blake Shoddy having himself a first half.
Yeah, their Eagles' O-line's just opening up big holes for him to get through.
Blake Shoddy with the carry. Tackle made by Preston Petrusso.
Right there, Preston Petrusik with the tackle, trying to stop Blake Shoddy. We'll try it again here, second down for the Eagles. They got 3 yards to gain. And Shoddy is going to get a few. With 2 minutes and change left.
Third and short once again.
Shoddy again with another rushing attempt. Let's throw it down to our third man on crew. Brock Booth, what are you seeing down there, Brock?
Now, vibes were a little bit low. I mean, in the first quarter, we had a little bit of a slow start for the boys, and you could tell that it was getting to everybody a little bit. Everybody was a little bit down on each other, but you did have offensive leaders stepping up and saying, hey, guys, we got to get together. A lot of the offense said, keep your heads up. We got this. In the second quarter, we saw a little bit more of a momentum build as we got that safety in the end zone, but they haven't been really been able to contain Blake Schotte, the running back from Alabama, the senior, who has run all over the field so far. And it's evident that he's getting to the outside and taking care of these RPOs and setting up their entire offense. So it'll be important that at the remainder of this game and in the second half that they contain Blake Schotte and that they get this offense going.
Thank you, Brock. Again, a lot we've talked about trying to contain the running game here for the Duhawks. I can only imagine what's going in the heads of Coach Helminiak and company. I mean, it's quite impressive what Benedictine has done here so far. Of course, they're looking to add on some more yards here with the two-minute timeout. Third and three on the 24. Wyjewski hands it off once again. There's our guy, Schotte. He's going to take a loss of yards and a quick fourth down for the Duhawks. Again, exactly what you want, trying to head into half.
Yeah, another thing you've seen from this Loras defense as what's going on is you're seeing a lot more gang tackles rather than, you know, the solo tackles on the running backs.
It looks like the officials have motioned. All right, it's a timeout charge to the Duhawks. Perhaps try and get a couple of quick snaps off. Certainly plenty of time left on the clock for the Duhawks to get something going.
Yeah, you're just trying to preserve as much time as you can. They'll have one more timeout left for this potential last drive of the half, depending on where they get the ball at.
.143 left in this second quarter. Benedictine taking their time, talking through some things.
Yeah, third down conversion has been very low for both sides so far.
Which comes as a shock for Benedictine, and I say that because of how dominant they were against the Beavers in Storm Lake last week.
Yeah, it's been kind of surprising.
The punt is off, nearly blocked by special teams, and the Duhawks are going to try and return it. Not much yardage gained there. Nonetheless, we'll see another first down with 1:33 to go.
Yeah, they're just about midfield, so you're hoping for a touchdown, but if you can get into field goal range, that's just as good.
And, of course, for Ian Brocious, as he returned there for a few yards, doing a good job on special teams. Mm-hmm. Now up to England and company. That was quite a hit there. Yeah. As we're looking at replay of that return. Now the offense has their chance, David, to try and make a statement.
Half second later, it's probably another 15 for the Duhawks.
Easily. England is going to look downfield, and he's going to throw. He finds a man open and a quick throw. Yes. And there he is right there, Ian Brocious, with the catch.
That's his second throw over the middle of the field for the Duhawks today. I mean, you just haven't seen yet.
England looking over at Cahill, and he is brought down not too early for the first down marker.
Yeah, I think the defense might have got a finger on that ball.
I think so, too. The ball kind of wobbled a little bit. We'll try and take a look at it here. On second and nine. England. He's got a throw to his right. He's got a man. That's Ian Brocious. And he's out of bounds. Very smart timing play. Of course, being aware of where the clock is at. 56 seconds left in this first half.
Yeah, you're moving the ball fairly well so far right now.
Cahill going to take it down the middle.
Again, you're in field goal range right here. Second down. You're just hoping, you know, can't take negative plays out of it.
It would be a rare 5 points on the board for the Duhawks. 36 and change coming down in the first half. England, he's going to find a man. It is picked off for the Eagles. That pass was intended to see the hands of Jaheim Hayes.
Yeah, that's just a tough throw to make.
And that's a vibe killer.
Another flag thrown.
Although the offense is
personal, I don't know.
Whoa. Ooh, let's take a look at the replay here.
After play, dead ball, unfortunate conduct, and Ben Dixon, number 5. 15 yards from the hitting run. First down, Ben Dixon. That is number 5, first unfortunate conduct penalty of the game.
Yeah, if he gets another personal foul, he's out of the game. Oh, that's a drive killer right there.
That really is.
Again, you can't make those kind of plays.
And it would have been a great play. You just got to get the ball up just a little bit more, where the ball's not within jumping range there for the Eagles.
Benedict, if I could take this into half.
Yeah.
Clock run out.
So they'll go into formation there. And both teams going to head to their sides to talk things over. And it is a 14-2 lead here for the Eagles. Once again, we'll head into half in just a second. And let's throw it down to our third man on the crew, Brock Booth. Brock.
Coach, down at the half, what's the message to the team going into the locker room?
Hey, same as it was before the game. We've got too many guys not taking care of business out there. We're doing everything we can to lose this football game. You know, we're turning the ball over. We've got penalties. All right, we're not executing. We're not aligning right. So we got to fix those things at half so that we can come out and give ourselves an opportunity to win the football game.
What adjustments do you need to make in the second half to turn this around?
Well, like I said, we our guys have to make sure they're doing their 111. Everyone's got to be doing their 111. All right. So if each guy's doing their job, we're going to be just fine. We need to calm down, play our game, and we're just going to be fine. You know, we got to not turn the ball over. All right. We got to take advantage of opportunities when they're presented, which we haven't done, and we've got to do our jobs.
All right. Thank you, Coach.
All right. Thank you, Brock. And we'll take a break here. Of course, you just heard Coach Helminiak talk about players doing their 111s, and I mean, you just got to take care of the football, and it just comes down to that every play.
Yeah, you saw costly penalties. 3 turnovers here in the first half for Loras. Limit those, and it might be a different game.
Definitely. 14-2, your score. Eagles taking a big lead here. We'll come back here. We've got 18 minutes on the clock, and we'll see you back here at the Rock Bowl. And welcome back. Again, a beautiful night for football. Just take a look at that skyline. I mean, my God, that's beautiful.
Doesn't get better than the Duke skylines.
Doesn't. So here's the story. For those of you just joining us, or for those of you who have continued to watch us through that halftime break, it's 14-2, excuse me. Not 42. Not yet. But the story has been all Eagles. Both sides of the ball, offense, defense, special teams. But for those of you that weren't able to watch us, we did have an interview with Coach Helminiak. And he was very brutally honest, right, saying everybody's got to take care of their 111s. But in layman's terms, it means you just got to take care of your duty, do your job, and everything will fall into place.
Oh, yeah. That was a rough first half from them. You're hoping to see a better second half, and I think you will. Because as they were going through the second quarter, they were kind of, you know, getting better defensively, stopping the run, and kind of making Wojciechowski, you know, beat them.
Yeah, it's a battle of the Evans here at quarterback. We will see the Duhawks on defense to start out this second half. And just like what Coach Helminiak said, look, it's not just the offense. It's not the job. On defense, you've got to stick with your assignment, whether that's man coverage or it's a zone coverage. You got to be able to take care of it. We'll see what kind of adjustments they've made, certainly for the Duhawks as well as the Benedictine Eagles. What's something that the Eagles can improve on for the second half?
Getting the ball back into Blake Shoddy's hands. They kind of went away from that as they ended the first half.
quite a statement made for the Eagles, and that was a big run.
Yeah,
big return.
Duhok player down. He's got thrown after that play. That was wow. That was a great return for them. Very great return. And that's exactly what you need, right? Send the message to the Duhawks that, hey, look, we're not letting up on the gas. Good block in there from the Eagles on that kick return. That was daylight.
Yeah, that helped daylight. Set up this first and 10 on the 46. The Eagles are a knocking. Here's Shoddy. He's going to run it up the gut. Very similar to the first mm-hmm. half, of course.
Both teams are rested, so we're kind of going to see what we saw in the beginning of the game.
Now let's take a look at some of those second quarter stats. Benedictine with 26 receiving yards, and Lawrence blew him out of the water. It was 64 receiving yards. Mm-hmm. So, Evan, while we've been praising his running game, but he's also a dual threat quarterback, as we know, great at throwing the ball as well. Here's Wydajewski. Giving it to Shoddy. He bounces, and he's going to break another low tackle. He's done that a lot tonight.
Shoddy with another rushing attempt.
Yeah, Lawrence had more rushing yards than in that second quarter, which compared to that first quarter was drastic.
Spot of the ball is the we'll take a look at a replay here. He bounces off here, and a couple of Duhawks trying to take him down. A big third down stop if the Duhawks can help themselves. Just a little bit. Third and three on the 48. Wydajewski, he's going to look left. He's going to take it himself, throw it, and it is nowhere on the ground. And it looks like there's going to be a flag
might
in the backfield.
Roughing the passer, I believe. I saw Wydajewski get up, so I'm assuming that's what they're going to call. He thought about running there until he saw that play, and...
And they fooled us a couple of times mm-hmm. so far.
He thought about running, but he slipped in that pocket and, you know, delivered a ball that was overthrown.
Of course, the officials.
Push the foul, roughing the process, drop to the head. Number 40 on the defense, 15 yards, automatic first down.
The officials with a big call there, David. Now, yeah. what does that mean here for the Duhawk defense? And some may agree with that call, some may not, but reality is you still got 15 yards on that and automatic first down. What does the defense have to do now? What have to be cautious of?
Allowing anything deep, because you are at your – they're on your side of the field. You got to make sure that they don't get into the end zone at this point, because that brings a new life into that offense. Those kind of penalties where, you know, you're kind of backed up, you know, hitting third, fourth down. Now it's reset of downs, and he was flying back again.
Shoddy once again with that carry. Second and eight on the 31. He is having himself quite the day here, and it's just really impressive to see.
Yeah, he's a phenomenal running back. He's over 100 yards.
Again, taken up here. And that should put him over 140 yards so far in this game. Quite impressive.
Yeah, things are a little chippy if you can't tell.
Yeah.
It's one of those games.
And we talked about that. There were a couple of plays, particularly in the first quarter, where things were a little chippy. Not as much mm-hmm. in the second quarter.
No.
But now I feel like it's going to start ramping up just a little bit more.
Yeah, football is an emotional sport, and it gets to that. It's a contact sport.
Huge. Yeah.
Loud crowd right now.
Very loud, loud purple chants. Here's Wydajewski. He's going to find a man and almost picked for the Duhawks. Again, that was Brandon Glover, freshman making himself very available on the stat sheet. And here's the replay. Wydajewski almost, but we've seen this before. Mm-hmm. In the second quarter, if you remember correctly, there was another throw like this on the right side, yep. And the receiver just stops mid-route, expecting the ball to come to him when it's almost picked mm-hmm. off.
Yeah, Glover did a great job jumping that route right there to get himself in a position to make a play.
fourth and six on the 30. They're going to go for it. Wydajewski's going to find a man, and he's got more yards tackled on. And the risk pays off.
These Eagles guys, they don't stop. They keep going.
Tackle is made by Owen Kelly. First down for the Eagles.
We'll take a look here on the replay.
Yeah, Zacchaeus Knighton wrapping him up, but he's broke the tackle.
First and goal for the Eagles for the first time in this half. A couple of receivers wide on your screen there. Wydajewski's going to give it to Shoddy. Shoddy's going to pounce around. Finally brought down for second.
This is a big drive for both teams.
Very huge drive.
Very, it sets the tone for the second half.
Second and goal for the six.
Eagles needing six more yards for another touchdown. Looks like they're going to get into similar formation as the last play. Wydajewski's going to motion a receiver wide to your left. Wydajewski's going to shovel it up to Shoddy. Shoddy on his knees. He's going to go down to about the 2 yard line.
Yeah, that was a crack toss right there. A scheme you see a lot in those spread offenses.
And it works well in this offense because, as we've seen, Shoddy's a power forward running back. And what I mean by that is he's not easily brought down. And you can do that with him running wide.
Yeah, he has quick feet and he can break those tackles. It's impressive.
Third and three on the 3 for the Eagles. Knocking on the door of the end zone. Shoddy in the backfield. I think that's no surprise here. And Wydajewski, what a play for the Benedictine Eagles. It results in another touchdown. My goodness.
Pass is caught by Justin Hopper. Result of the play is a touchdown for Benedictine.
And that shades of Army and Navy, the offense.
Like, oh,
running,
definitely.
Running out of the wishbone with, you know, putting that wing in motion.
And the extra point is good.
Extra point is good.
We'll take a look at the replay here. A great fake to Shoddy, man open. Nobody near him on that Duhawk defense.
No. And they sort of that motion that we saw in the first half on this side, you know, this side of the field. And they like that little wishbone formation at the goal line. And it's worked.
And it brings us to a 21-2 lead here for the Eagles. Not the night so far that the Duhawks are looking for. But the offense is going to come back out here. And the Rock Bowl, I think we need the atmosphere here to be brought up a little bit.
Yeah, you know, you're down on the scoreboard, but the game's not over. Instead, it's football. It can change in an instant.
10 minutes, 6 seconds here.
And that was a good drive for Benedictine. They took time off the clock that Norris could have used.
It was very effective. Mm-hmm. I mean, short throws, you had a little bit of everything there, and a lot of it was the run game. Blake Shoddy continues to be a great asset for this Benedictine Eagles team. And I can't see it stopping anytime soon.
No.
I really can't.
He's done his job. He's done what his team's asked him to do.
The return team going to try and bring it in. Here's Zacchaeus Knighton down the sideline. He's got room. And that'll bring some life back to the Rock Bowl.
Man, what a return.
When you need him most, David,
oh, yeah.
He's there. And here it is. And here it is. Great blocking. You saw 41 pancake to the ground. And that was a big part of that run. If 41 does not get blocked there, you're easily going to end up seeing
Oh, yeah.
Zacchaeus Knighton on the 40 which is well far back to where they are at right now.
Yeah, great blocking on the return. Just set them up in great field position.
Cahill's going to take it. He's bottled up for a quick second down for England and company.
Yeah, if you're Lures, you want to walk with any points possible. Field goal, touchdown, or anything.
Second down.
You just need to be able to plunge through that defensive line, and that's been a big problem tonight.
Yeah, you don't want to get too ahead of yourself either. You want to make your plays and just make sure you do your job.
Man motions left of Evan England. He's going to hand it off to Cahill once again, and there you go. Cahill getting some good yards there. He's fighting for every yard, bringing about third and short to the first down marker.
Yeah, another great push from that D-Walk offensive line.
Again, hurry up offense, catching this defense kind of off guard here.
They're utilizing a lot of hurry up too, no huddle, kind of what they do most of the time. But let's do another tempo today.
England, he's got the ball. He's going to hand it to Cahill once again, and easily a first down for the Duhawks.
Hey, look at that offense there. They're hyped right now.
And rightfully so. You got to get rocking here for another first down at the 23. Looks like there's two in the backfield. Here you go. Cahill handoff for the Duhawks. He doesn't know where to go. And he'll be settled down, maybe a yard short.
Yeah, wanted to bounce outside, but kind of got trapped.
And you could see the hesitation of, okay, do I go left? Do I go right? But he tried to ultimately just shimmy a little bit up.
Yeah. And, you know, not a terrible loss. You don't want to go backwards, but you put your offense in a spot where, you know, still have room to make plays.
Second and 11, now at the 29. A lot of run game here. We'll see a throw pass from England. Potentially, he's going to take it. He's going to take it out of bounds. Very smart. As a quarterback, you don't want to lean into guys. So if you've got the room, David, it makes way more sense to go out of bounds.
Yeah, you know, that's a little shark wheel play right there. You send the halfback in motion on a wheel route. Ultimately, wasn't open. Evan did it himself.
You call it shark wheel play. I call it Jaws. Here's third and five on the 18. England, he's going to find a man open. A nice short pass. And, oh, what a hurdle there for the Duhawks. That was Ian Brosh. Excuse me, that was Brock Couch. And it's first and goal for the first time today.
Yeah, this is by far the Duhawks' best drive so far.
And you see here, could have easily been a sack if it weren't the right coverage on that offensive line. And a nice little jump play there.
Hey, you sent Drew Randall in motion.
Yeah. Hand off to Cahill. Cahill's going to power it in for a Duhawk touchdown.
That's a response drive you want.
Found a hole, he found an opening, he ultimately squeezed right through, and the first touchdown this season for the Duhawks.
Yeah, that was a great play. The O-line was phenomenal this drive.
And it gives us a chance to see Scotty Talmadge, senior kicker here for the Duhawks, for the extra point. It is up, and it is good. So our score now is 21-9. Definitely the best drive of the day, hands down for the Duhawks. What were some of the key plays here for the Duhawks?
Those runs in the middle. They set a tone that you're going to keep running down their throat, and it started with the O-line just making those plays.
Let's send it down to the third member of our broadcast booth. Brock, what do you got for us on the sideline?
Yeah, guys, coming out of halftime, these guys were out here dancing. They were ready to go. And it seemed that there was a quiet comfortability, for being in this spot. It's a 10-22 game now. It is a 21-9 game now, excuse me, and these guys felt a quiet comfortability. They were ready to go. And they came out after a bit of a demoralizing first drive, and they eventually punched a touchdown in. And that just goes to show their character, and that goes to show the message that Coach Hominiak sent them is getting through, guys. We'll look to see more of that the rest of the game.
And David, that's exactly what Coach Hominiak talked about. You take care of the football, you take care of your job, and that's how you build these touchdowns, drive after drive.
Those in the first half, we saw three costly turnovers that ended drives.
The kick.
Out of bounds.
Out, yep. And here we'll take a look at another replay of that touchdown there for Cahill. His first of the year, of course, and it just kind of seemed like the defense kind of gave up. They said, oh, the train's coming. We better get out of the way.
Yeah, great job by the right guard and right tackle, except, you know, creating that hole for him.
And now we'll settle in on Benedictine's first drive after the touchdown here. First and 10 on the 35.
Yeah, both teams came out of half with a touchdown drive.
It'll be fascinating to see what kind of drive the Eagles put together. Low snap, they're going to hand it off. And the Duhawks not taking any chance on stopping that ball. They do, thankfully, for second down.
Yeah, you got a veteran defensive line here, and they just know what's coming. Good play recognition from these guys.
A couple of substitutions here for the Duhawks. Would be quite a change of events if they can try and stop the football here.
Yeah, you have the momentum on your side after that touchdown. Getting a stop here just does wonders for you.
Second and 9, the handoff. And the Eagles are just going to take it for even more yardage. It is a third down.
Stevens Jr. with another rushing attempt.
Of course, that was Souza with the ball. Yeah. An injured Duhawk on the field. But, David, last year it was a lot of score, don't score drives for the Duhawks. And really just trying to focus in and try and take over a football game. So that's been their trickiest part the last couple of seasons. What do you have got for momentum? I mean, it's a big, and we've talked about it, it's a big game influencer, but especially in times like this for the Duhawks, right? You're coming off a really good drive and, you know, thinking about, and you had a week to think about the Hope game last week, you know. What's to say, to Brock's credit, about this team's spirit of staying alive?
You can tell these guys really enjoy the game, and, you know, those kind of guys, when a going gets tough, you see them prevail the most. And these guys, they're coming out really, really looking good after that first drive. And with momentum, you know, if you get the stop here on third down, which we got Benedictine's at 3-for-8 on third downs today, it's a big stop. Potential another score, you're back within score.
So the injured player is off the field right now. Third and 3 on the 42 for Benedictine. They'll get another crack at it. Duhawk fans getting louder here. Wojcicki's going to drop back, throw, and the bullet pass is good. And you can move the chains because it's first down.
That was close to being short. Every single one of those passes we've seen from Benedictine been out of play action.
Passes complete to Alex Corbett.
Which we haven't seen a lot of the Duhawks do. It's a lot of short, long, and then just run plays, right?
Yeah.
So do you expect for the rest of this game, David, to see a lot of play action from either side?
Mostly from Benedictine. That's what they've been relying on the entire game.
And another monster run. We've got a couple flags down.
Yeah, I would assume it's holding. Maybe some of the first ones at the being in the offensive backfield.
We'll see what the officials say here.
Yep.
You got a big crystal ball over there,
I do.
We'll take a look at the holding call in just a moment.
Yeah, I can see it right there. Just tackled into the ground.
Can't do that.
Nope. Is that one fan yelled?
So play resumes.
Yeah, that's a big break for Duhok defense.
Yeah, and look, it's 1st and 20 on the 36. You don't see that often against this Benedictine team. Wojewski's going to drop back, look immediately to his right. He's got a man downfield and overshot.
Man, that potential to be a big play right there.
And again, that was Zacchaeus Knighton on the coverage. He's stepping up.
Oh, yeah.
Stepping up on defense.
No. Didn't know he was return, you know, after last year, but he did, and he's really playing well this year.
Certainly a fan favorite player here on the campus of Loras College.
Playmaker on defense, too.
Oh, most definitely. He can, yeah. Second and long for Wojewski. He's going to take it himself. A nice play, fake handoff to Shoddy. Only amounts to a few yards.
Yeah, that was a nice read option. He didn't see the defensive end crash in, so he decided to keep it.
We're seeing the sun set here in Dubuque, and the sun setting on another quarter with 4 and change left. 3rd and 17 from the 38.
If you're the D-Log defense, you want to play the sticks on this play. Keep everything short of that first down marker.
See a lot of options for Wojewski on that right side on the top of your screen. Looks like a timeout's going to be called here.
Delay a game?
Delay a game?
I don't know.
What's going on? Yeah, delay a game. The crystal ball for David. There you go.
That was.
Fans, of course, liking that call.
Even harder for conversion here for Benedictine.
3rd and 23 from the 33. Say that 10 times fast. It looks like Wojewski's trying to read a play here. We'll see what the Eagles draw up. Two wide on each side for Wojewski. He's got options. He's open. He's going to take it himself. Juke around, and he's going to be brought down by the 40-yard line. It'll be a 4th and long. But again, to what you said, it's very hard to try and complete those long 3rd and outs.
Yeah, that's why you see a lot of teams run a screen on those 3rd and longs, because you have a higher chance of working at that than you do with a deep pass.
And fantastic defense, right, for the Duhawks. That line doing everything they can. And then just to make the tackle right there.
Yeah, and good job of the secondary, too. They had everything boxed up.
So special teams for the Eagles. And another good punt. Ian Brosh is going to try and make a move here. And he gets down just at the 25.
Yeah, saved a bunch of yards in that one, too.
Just the low line drive, which we haven't seen from special teams today. We really haven't.
The Duhawk special teamers doing a good job getting in on that punt, too.
So that brings us to 2:40 left in this third. And a great defensive drive there for the Duhawks. Now momentum on their side. Let's see what Evan England can do with the ball. We got a stoppage of play. Looks like they're trying to check the chains. Make sure they've got everything ready. They do. And we'll see 1st and 10 at the 25 for the Duhawks. England with the ball. He's going to look, see what his options are. He's got a man downfield. Brock Couch nearly makes it. Wow.
Second time we've seen both those guys not on the same page on those deep passes.
And And the official's going to take a look here at something.
Another flag?
Holding defense, number five.
What a fortunate break for the Duhawks. My goodness.
I didn't see, you know, to pay attention to that. I didn't see the hold, but nice little break for the Duhawks.
Well, and that's huge because let's take a look at this.
Oh, yeah.
Yep. Sets us up for another first and 10, this time on the 35. The handoff from England to Cahill. Cahill's going to get a couple of yards. Defense able to bottle him up there. And they'll set up second and 6.
Yeah, again, 3 to 4 yards every run. That's good. That's good. That's what we see very top level running backs accomplish.
Seeing a lot of progress. This is a different Duhawk offense than what we're seeing, what we're used to seeing typically, David. England is going to look left. He finds Hayes. Hayes is going to go out of bounds. Easy first down for the Duhawks. And you can't give me more cowbell on that one, fans. And we got another flag. We'll take a look to see what's going on here. First, the replay of the Hayes catch. Nobody near him within a mile almost.
And that hole going back.
It'll be interesting to see what it is. The fans are very hyped up for this one.
I don't know really what it is.
I think it could have gone either way.
Yeah,
we'll take a look here.
Good ball. Unfortunate conduct. Number 4. The defense. 15 yards.
And that's a big 15-yard gain here for the Duhawks. Sets up yet again another first down. And for the Duhawks, this is exactly what you need. Sometimes it's luck that just kind of goes on your side, and you need those breaks when you can get them, right? You will never complain about that.
Two big penalties on this drive against that defense. The hold and the unsportsmanlike, 25 yards in penalties.
England's going to find Hayes again. Hayes is going to go outside. Grab more yards, set up a second down. Again, fans loving it here. On a packed Rock Bowl. We'll see second and 4 after this replay, and Hayes just wide open yet again. That's the second straight play.
Mm-hmm.
Second and 4 on the 33. England's going to drop back. He's going to find a man. Can he get Couch? And no call there. Great coverage by the defense.
Yeah, that was close. That could have gone either way, really.
I guess the fans were trying to look at a PI potentially there, pass interference.
Yeah, that was a lot of contact in that play, but it was a play that could have gone each way.
Well, let's take a look. Let's see if there was any contact. There, it looks like there was early contact there. It seemed like it hindered Couch's ability to try and make a move.
Yeah, what saved the defense from receiving a penalty there was the DB looking back at the ball.
And, of course,
trying to play the ball.
And that was senior DB Joshua Coates breaking up the coverage there. And Cahill's going to get bottlenecked here on a fourth down. Excuse me, third down. That set us up for a fourth down. Fourth and 3 on the 32. You could go really risky here, David. What's your bet?
You go for it. In this game, in the momentum the way it's at, you go for it. A little too far for a field goal.
Although we know Scotty's got the legs.
Oh,
he's done it before. But they're going to leave the offense here. Man motion left for England. He's going to look immediately to his right, and it looks like forward progress. We'll see what the officials call it.
Yeah,
but that pass was great. Great. That's exactly what you need. And Brock Couch was made available, came back for the ball, and it's going to be a first down.
Yeah, I was kind of wondering what they were going to replay with him going back, but they gave him the forward progress.
Seemed very tight, though. Let's take a look here on yet another first and 10 at the 27. England, he's going to look. He's going to take it himself. Stay behind the line, and he's just gonna, he would rather take that and slide. And it's easy yards there.
Yeah,
looks like he'll be just short of the marker.
That's a heads up play right there by Evan England.
Yep. It's the end of the third quarter.
And, of course, that signals the end of the third quarter. Time's certainly flying by here at the Rock Bowl. It's 21-9. We're going to begin the fourth. And David, this is night and day difference.
Oh, yeah. This is complete different team than we saw in that first half. They're firing on all cylinders. They're making plays. And they're just, it's been a massive time for them. Massive difference.
And so we welcome you back in the booth once again. I'm Ryan Haywood. He's David Peters. David, let's run through some of these stats here, particularly first downs. Benedictine with 3, Loris with 6. And I think that speaks volumes to what Coach Helminiak talked to us about, and Brock as well, as they had the interview. But Coach H definitely knowing what to do in these scenarios.
Oh, yeah.
And again, this is his 11th season as head coach helming the Loris College Duhawks. And again, we'll see where it ends up this season. And it's speaking volumes now in this game, this expertise and this wealth of knowledge, knowing what to do in situational football as we approach a 2nd and 3 at the 18.
Yeah, whatever he told his team in the half really stuck with them and really put them on fire.
Let's hope that they can stick to it. We did get a couple of whistles blown here before play started.
Probably procedure, because refs weren't ready yet.
And you can hear Coach H very vocal on the sideline, and that's very, very good that your leader is vocal on the sideline, telling your guys what to do. Try to direct them as much as you can.
It's important second down right here.
Looks like, are they looking potentially at the spot of the ball?
Yeah, that's what I was thinking.
Maybe the chain?
2nd and 10. 3rd and 10. 2nd and 10. Hard to see, though. Down marker over here. Yeah, they're moving the chains. It's okay, it is 2nd and 3. I was kind of confused they had the marker at 2nd and 10.
So the chain gang getting some help on the sidelines.
Hard job.
Oh, certainly.
It's hard job. I've done it before. It's not the easiest.
All right, let's see it, David. 2nd and 3. England's going to find open receiver, and it'll be a first down.
Yeah. Norris has done a good job not having turnovers. That's been their biggest benefit so far.
And again, that was tight end Jacob Tedro with the catch. Sets up another first down, and here we go for the Duhawks.
Not quite first and goal.
England finds Couch, and Couch isn't going down early. Going to grab a few yards, sets up another 2nd and short. And he has stepped it up today. I think so far he has been their first star of the game. Being available, trying to make the catches that he needs to, helping Evan out and this offense.
No, we were talking pregame about these guys that we think should make a difference, and he was one of mine. He was, it's his first chance to really elevate that role. He's a sophomore this year.
And Cahill with a great run. He's also stepped up, talking about players stepping up.
Oh,
he's helping to set up this first and goal on the 3-yard line.
A lot of first-year starters for the Duhawks, and they've really played their role as well. Young team.
.13-32 left in this fourth quarter. England claps, gets the ball. He's going to hand it off for another touchdown for the Duhawks. Play Chelsea in the Rock Bowl. 21 for Benedictine and 15 for the Duhawks for the time being.
What a turn of events here.
And the Duhok offense is staying out there. They're going to go for it.
Damn.
And it's bottled up for the Duhawks.
Cahill
was brought down very short.
And he's saving the goal from the 4-yard line.
Oh, the third and goal. Wait a minute.
I thought they scored.
Wait a minute. And the fans, some of the fans are confused too.
Didn't they call it a touch? I swear the far.
Madness at the Rock Bowl. And we saw Cahill go in. There was no warning, no signal.
Yeah, they gave a signal.
They played
the
Chelsea. I mean, you had everything going. The fans were pumped. And you heard the timeout calls there pretty loud. Evan is very visibly angry.
Yeah.
He can't believe it.
We saw the referee on the far side give the touchdown signal. That's what I thought was in.
And so right now, it's 21-9. So it's not 21-15 like I had mentioned.
No, yeah. I was confused.
So here's what's happened. Here's what's happened. So instead of it being second and goal for the Duhawks, you've now got a third and four on the 4-yard line, of course.
Yeah.
12:25 left in the fourth quarter. But now you're just going to start worrying about time if you're this Duhawk offense.
I'm confused on that spot, too. I thought he was closer than where they have him.
Regardless, we'll see the offense come back out.
Packed house here in the Rock Bowl.
It's starting to get loud here. Hearing more cowbell. The fans want to see a win. They want to see a comeback. Can they do it? Evan England takes the ball. He's got to run to his left, and he's in. No, is he short? Let's see where they spot it. His helmet is off. They're going to stop the clock.
So he'll have to come out for a play with his helmet coming off. Oh, he looks shaken up.
Evan England looking a little rough.
You
see a couple of the trainers on the side trying to talk to him. We'll see what's going on here. Let's take a look at the replay here, David. And it's a smart play to take it, but you just hope that he's okay.
Yeah, it was a QB power, and yeah, that was a tough hit.
And you can hear the fans clapping. He is getting up on his own power. We'll see the status of him for the rest of this game. We'll closely monitor that. But in the meantime, we're going to see Garrett Hutchinson, the senior, take some snaps.
Yeah, we saw him come in last week after Evan got hurt after another big hit.
Yeah, and he was 2 for 2 for 4 yards against Buena Vista.
Going for it.
And they're going to go for it. Wait a minute. It does not look like.
Shotgun?
Does not look like they're going to settle for a field goal. The snap up. Good. We got a couple flags at first. At first, it's another touchdown for Cahill. We do have a flag down on the right side of the field, though. So hold on really quick. We'll take a look to see what the officials say.
Offsides? I don't know. It's kind of, where that flag's at, it's hard to tell.
Absolute craziness the last minute.
Holding? All right, defense penalty.
So, of course, the touchdown will stand now. Now we can say it's 21-15, 12:03 left, and Scotty Talmadge, the senior kicker, will get another shot at a PAT.
Had to bring within 5.
Fans very loud for this. kick is up. It is good, and Loris is nowhere out of this game yet. Let's take a look at the replay here. And Hutchinson, it's a clean, clean pass off to Cahill, but you saw that defensive line creep in just a little bit. If it were any later, it could have been dead in the water.
Oh, yeah. You know, you're at the goal line. Those plays typically are actually harder than playing from outside the five.
Oh, certainly.
Because you have such a you have so much less room than you would think.
Of course, the fight song ringing out in the Rock Bowl. Fans very excited for that. And now it's a 21-16 game.
Yeah, the Duhok defense is going to want to come out here and get a big stop again. Give the offense the ball. This is very similar to last year's game.
It is. And in a game where we saw so much twist and turns, the narrative has seemingly come back between these two, and dare I say, rivals now.
Oh, yeah. That's how a lot of those guys on that team feel.
So I expect to see a lot of chippiness, of course, down on the field the rest of this game. We'll see where things lie, but for now, the Eagles are going to take it back to right about the 25-yard line.
Yeah, this is their seventh time all time. Their seventh matchup all time. Loris is 5-1 against them, 3-0 at home.
So something's going to give here tonight, folks. Don't change your broadcast.
So Loris escaped last year, 42-41.
And we were talking about it in the pregame that, look, we expected it to be a closer game. Hence why we were shocked at how much of a blow it seemed to be in that first half.
Yeah, Loris has come out and done a better job containing the run than they did in the first quarter.
Wyjewski's going to hand it off. And Shoddy's going to get some more yards out of that than he probably should have. But regardless, it's a second and short.
Yeah, the nice thing about those long offensive drives is your defense comes out rested.
Second and four on the 33. Second down. And the tempo between offenses is very interesting to note because we're used to seeing the Duhawks to hurry up. You got to go. Get the ball out as quick as you can. Catch the defense off guard. Here, seemingly a different approach, like you had mentioned earlier in the broadcast. Take your time with it and see where things are at with the play call. Wyjewski's going to find a man open top of your screen, taken down, and it looks like it'll set up for pass a third down. Yep, they're just going to move the chains.
I was going to say third and an inch right
now. I was like, how close are we splitting hairs here?
Yeah, we need a note card back out.
Eagles staring at a first and 10 on their 36. Actually, maybe 36. Man motions left of Wyjewski. You can see the Wyjewski going to hand it off. Shot is going to get bottled up, and what a stop for the Duhawks.
Those are the kind of plays you need.
And what a play there, the fans. Very excited for it. Now let's take a look at the replay and the stop courtesy of Michael Carney. And a fantastic stop at that.
Yeah, that was a big play right there.
And here's yet another second and long for the Eagles. They weren't able to convert it on their last offensive drive. Let's see what they do here with just under 10 minutes left. Wyjewski. He's going to hand it off to Shoddy once again, trying to regain some of that yardage, and it's going to be a third down.
Very similar back to where they started. Well, third and 10.
Yeah, third and 10 on the 36.
Again, third and long, keep everything in front of the sticks.
Subs coming in for the Duhawks on defense. And that sideline getting very amped up right now. Rightfully so. The Rock Bowl is rocking. Third down. Wojciechowski looks left immediately, and no play on that one.
Another stop here for D-Walk defense.
And that's a huge stop for this defense.
This is, again, brand new team in the second half.
And it just seemed like Wojciechowski ran out of room to throw it. And obviously, as we're seeing here on the replay, you just got to throw it out.
Yep.
You just got to throw it out. But you do got to be mindful, right? We've seen that awareness of quarterbacks in the past, right? You got to be aware of the ball at all times. Mm-hmm. But now, regardless, you got to punt. And it's caught! Oh, my goodness! And the Duhawks are going to get the ball! Oh, my goodness! Oh, my goodness! It's another touchback! Wow!
What a turn!
Listen to this crowd!
Wow! What a turn of events! Chelsea Dagger once again!
Oh my goodness!
Like I said, one of these times they're gonna get a punt block because of how much pressure the D-Lops bring in. And what happened? It happened right there.
And an explosion of energy that is concentrated on the Rock Bowl has seemingly lifted the Duhawks to a 22-21 lead with 8 minutes and change to go.
Wow.
What a turn of events.
Duhawks have the lead.
Their first lead of the game and arguably the most important one thus far.
We've seen, you know, historically what special teams plays can do.
And what did I say earlier? Special teams, special plays, special players. We'll get a timeout here on the Duhawks, it seems.
Yeah, special teams can make or break a game. We saw that in college and the NFL these past few weeks.
It's an integral part of the game. You need those guys to be able to step up and make your plays, even if you don't block it, to try and cover your man, especially on that front. And it does seem as though quarterback Garrett Hutchinson is still in the game. There he is on your screen, number 10.
Yeah, we see Evan kind of being worked on in the bench area.
So the offense is going to take another stab at it, try to get more points. Hutchinson looks over to his right, and it's blocked out. And there were a couple of hands on it for the defense. The two-point no good, of course. The Eagles snuffed that one out pretty good. But David, a 22-21 lead for the Duhawks.
This is another, crowd. It's deafening.
But what a fantastic play there on defense for Benedictine. Stepping up, making sure that there are no extra points going on the board. That was, of course, linebacker Keenan Davis for the Eagles. And
as that player, they just batted away.
And here we go.
Man,
buckle your seatbelts because we're in for quite a ride the next 8 minutes and 55 seconds.
This is, you said it since halftime, come on, brand new D-Walks team right here.
And in an evening where the winds have barely changed on the field, it seemingly seems like it has.
Wind's blowing the other direction now. Man, in primetime games, like everything feels so much more special as well.
You got the lights, you got everything going.
Big crowd, it's special.
The Eagles will have a chance to try and bring it back. And it's brought down. Barely any gain there.
This is a team effort right here. This turnaround has been a massive team effort.
Duhawks clawing their way throughout this entire game to try and find the right fitting. Both sides of the ball. And they've seemingly found it. Now it's about maintaining it as we take a look at that replay. And again, being brought down was Josh Coates.
And those blocks really didn't hold up for Benedictine.
So here's why Dejewski. He's going to hand it off. And Shotty goes nowhere.
And this defense entered a new level in the second half.
Brandon Fox with the tackle.
Now second and it's second to 10 on the 20. So Shotty gets up to the line of scrimmage. No gain. Time ticking away.
Yeah, this defense allowed just over 60 yards in the second half.
This is incredible, Dave. Wojcicki's gonna find Shotty. And he's gonna get through just for a few yards on third down.
Now this is...
Pass is coming through to Shotty. Tackle is made by...
Subs coming in, of course, David, and... When we talk about the late game stage, how important substitutions are. No matter if you are a starter or if you are a second string guy, you have a huge role to try and do your job. Here's Wojcicki. Oh, he dropped the ball! Oh my goodness! And the Duhawks are going to recover the ball!
We saw this in the first half. Turnovers were going against Loris. Loris seemingly turns it around. Two massive takeaways here.
We'll have to take a look at that because I'm not sure.
Assuming they call it a fumble.
And they have! First and 10 for the Duhawks. New set of downs. And here's the replay. Oh my goodness. And it seemed like... that was Brian Rodriguez, the sophomore D lineman with a hand on the ball there.
The young guys have been stepping up today for the Duhawks.
First and 10 for the Duhawks. Here's Hutchinson. He's going to hand it off once again to Cahill for positive yards. And it just seems like such an incredible moment for this program in this season. And it's a tale of two games going from 49-0 to so far a one-point lead.
Yeah, and, last week's game, you can dwell on that for 24 hours. After that, it's time to focus on the next one. And, man... This is one of those games that you love to have after a big loss like that.
12 seconds left on the play clock, David. We've got second and 5 on the 10. Hutchinson going to give it to Cahill once again. Doesn't work out this time.
Yeah, the momentum, assuming it stays this way, you love to have this heading into a conference game starting on next week.
Let's take a look at the replay here. In theory, a good play. You did see the penetration of that O-line. Yeah, way too easy.
The ball did come out at the end.
Yes.
So that's what I thought. I couldn't get a good view of that.
Yes.
Exactly. No, the ball did come out.
And fortunately for the Duhawks, they did recover it. Because otherwise, you end up exactly in the position where the Eagles find themselves in right now.
Yeah, great awareness as the ball came out.
Third and 5 at the 10. Hutchinson's going to try and find Hayes. Nowhere to be found. It's going to set up a fourth down. So, go ahead, David.
I would assume you bring out the field goal unit because you have the lead. You're playing with house money at this point. Extend that lead. Give yourself another bigger cushion.
And you do see Talmadge out here. Try and go for the field goal. We'll see where they're at.
Scotty's going to get ready. Ball set. The kick is up. And it is good. And the Duhawks now lead this game 25-21.
And momentum is a crazy thing.
Excuse me, it was no good. And sometimes with this view, David, it's hard to tell where the ball's going. Our producer letting us know that it was a little off. So the Eagles will take it over here. Excuse me, everybody. The Eagles will take it over here. And now for this Eagles offense, a chance at redemption to try and cover their mistakes. Wojcicki's going to find a man open. He's got some more yards. He cannot be stopped, and he's taken out of bounds.
Yeah, Coach O'Miniak's words really, really stuck with this team. What he told us at half, they're executing.
But now it's got to resound with that team now more than ever. This seems like it's going to be the biggest drive of the game. Let's take a look at that replay. And great defensive awareness to try and block the ball by that defense, by this Duhawk defense, but to no avail.
Again,
setting up another first down.
These are good wrap-ups by the defense, too.
The handoff to Shoddy, taken only for a few yards.
Stevens Jr. with the rushing attempt.
Excuse me, that was Stevens Jr. with the carry.
Second down from the 33.
Approaching 5 minutes left here. And
the most important 5 minutes of the game.
This is what it comes down to. The ability to make big plays at the right time.
Yeah, football is a sport where it can change in an instant.
Second and 7. And a good play for the Eagles to try and get some yardage.
Pass complete to
it's incomplete, of course.
Good job by the DB to blow up that blocker to get to the ball carrier.
And assuming it was
caught.
And if you remember, David, the first half, it looked like it was very tough for this Duhawk defense to make any tackles. Now they're employing that here now.
Oh, yeah. This is a completely different team. We've said numerous times. But this is a different thing we saw in that first half.
Third and 7. Wojcicki's going to find a man, and he is taken down. And it seems like it's going to be a first down.
Yeah.
Pass is caught by Justin Hoppe. Owen Curry on the tackle.
That will set us up a first and 10 once again on the 41. And for the Eagles, this is exactly what you need.
You want to come out here if you're Benedictine, control that clock, bring it down as far as you can. And if you're Loris, on the other hand, you want to make sure you get the ball back.
What a juice. He's got a man open downfield. Can he get there? He cannot. The deep ball, no good. And that was wide receiver Winston Brown out of Oviedo, Florida.
Pass is incomplete. Intended for Winston Brown. Second and 10.
And that was not a bad...
No.
It just wasn't a bad throw at all.
Yeah, the receiver was about a step and a half ahead, too. Not on the same page.
See a quick substitution here before the second down. Blake Shoddy in the backfield. Wojcicki's going to hand it to him. And Shoddy's going to get through for a few yards. Makes a man miss. And another set of first down.
Yeah, the Duhawks are going for that ball again.
And with time expiring, now it's about clock management.
Mm-hmm. How well can you use your timeouts if you're both sides?
We'll see how well they do. Fans getting loud here. Shoddy's got the ball. He's trying to find out where to go. He's taken down.
for a loss of yards.
Yeah,
in a game where he's been really impactful, David.
Oh, yeah, he's been their biggest player of the game.
They'll exchange some guys with that offense. And now second and 12 from the 49. Wyjewski finds a man open and plenty of room and a huge hit. He cannot be taken down, and it's another first down. We do have another injured player.
Lita is Quimaic Flynn. Can't see the number. Is it number 9? Oh, it is Brandon Glover.
Another injured Duhok down. Let's take a look at the replay.
And there was just, they're trying to knock the ball out too.
And that was Alexander Corbett with the catch there. Let's send it down to the third man on our crew. See if we can get an update from Brock. Yeah. Brock, take it away.
The fans came alive in the fourth quarter here. It's been all Duhawks, but obviously there's an injury on the field behind me, and right now Benedictine is driving down the field. The unsung hero for the Duhawks in the fourth quarter has been their special teams. A muff punt recovery earlier in the game. Dan Justo's pinned a couple punts deep in within the 5-yard line, and of course the blocked punt touchdown. It's been a clinic by John Powers' squad so far, but the defense needs to figure it out. Junior offensive tackle Caden Carnes said to his team, it's time to find out who we are. Guys,
do need to find out who this Lures squad is, and I think we're finding it out right now. Here's Shoddy with the ball.
Yeah, this is
gain of a few yards, David.
This is one of those drives that, how resilient can you be if they do all defense? And they're showing that they can, you know, they can get stopped when needed.
Michael Kearney with the stop there. Second down here for the Eagles. On the 29, we'll see a timeout here.
Yeah, we're at the 2-minute timeout.
Yeah. It's quite the turn of events. And so let's spell it out for everybody viewing at home. It was a very slow start for this Duhawk offense.
Yeah, 14-2
in the half. And at the half, you were like, okay, this team is in need of some answers. Coach H provided those answers for us. Play your guys. Take care of the football. Scrap away together, and that's exactly what they have done here. Now it's just about closing out the game. And with 2 minutes left, of course, not a whole lot of time, but enough time to try and make the final adjustments that you need.
Oh, yeah, this is the, again, most important time of the game. You're up by one. Can you get a stop here on defense?
So play will resume. Second and 8 on the 29. The Rock Bowl is rocking. Wyjewski looks left, and he finds a man, and it is not caught. It is an incomplete pass on the sideline. That is a huge stop, and it is third down.
And I think if you're Benedictine, you want to keep it on the ground and get as close to the sticks as you can and probably kick a field goal.
And as we take a look at what lies ahead in this season for Benedictine, next game will be at home in Lisle, Illinois, against Rockford University. So again, a big matchup there for both those squads. We'll see what kind of momentum they take heading out of this game. And Winston Brown's going to make a catch. Oh my goodness, what a find.
Wow.
And Zacchaeus Knighton had coverage on him until like the last couple of steps of that throw. Yeah,
that was good coverage by the defense too.
So the Duhawks are going to take a quick timeout to talk about that last play and adjustments. Wyjewski finds Winston Brown on a great, what looked like a great slant route, right? And you just find him open, and It's really impressive. Really impressive late game.
That was actually not Wojciechowski. That was backup quarterback Cooper.
That was, oh my goodness, yes.
Number five.
Yes,
I thought it was as well until we saw the replay. I saw number five. I was like, oh, wait. Actually, he's been, 5 for 7 today with 49 yards so far.
So we talked about the next matchup for Benedictine. Mm-hmm. For this Laura squad, they're going to be here against the team that Benedictine beat last week, Buena Vista. And that's going to be a 1 o'clock start time. No more night games the rest of the way in this regular season. But from here on out for the Dewhawks, it's all divisional matchups. You've got Buena Vista next week and week 4 going into Indianola and Buxton Stadium to play the Simpson Storm.
Yeah, these are crucial few games coming up.
Shoddy going for maybe a yard or two. We'll see where they place it. And it's Laura's taking yet again a second timeout. So, clock management, it's 1:46 left in the game. Each team has one timeout left.
Yeah, clock management's gonna be interesting in the last, few minutes, last minute and a half.
So that was a quick one. The defense seems ready. The offense taking a little bit more time to get set. It'll be, once our game starts back up, it'll be 2nd and 9 from the 16. So here we go. 2nd and 9 on a crucial drive late in this game. Shoddy is going to bounce around, and he's going to find a hole in this defense, and it's a touchdown for the Benedictine Eagles. Oh, no.
You have one timeout left with your Dewhawks. Got a big drive coming up.
And this Dewhawk crowd is stunned. And it just seemed like Shoddy had so much time to figure out where to go, and this defense had no answers.
Yeah, it was a tough, tough play. But you still have time. You have a timeout left.
So they're going to go for it. For an extra 2 points, there's a flag on the play. And Simmons Little's going to try and throw it out. It is no good. We'll get to see what this flag is on. It appears so.
Yeah.
Okay, so a big play there. And here's what it means for the Dewhawks. It's 27-22. Eagles have the lead. Once again.
Mm-hmm.
So all you really have to do is just march down the field. And it seems so simple. But if there's any indication of where this game's going, it's anyone's guess.
Yeah, we might see a finish similar to last year.
So let's take a look at this. Let's see. So Shoddy was originally going to go left. Of course, he read it and said there's nobody on that right side. It's a weak right side coverage. And the run defense today has largely stopped them in the second half. Now it's gone back to kind of the ways of that first half defense.
Yeah, that defense got bottled up on that play, leaving a lot of room on that right side of the offense.
.139 left in regulation. 27-22, Benedictine. They have marched their ways from Lyle to Dubuque. And they have taken over the Rock Bowl a couple of different times in this game. And they have reclaimed the lead. And now it is up to this Duhok offense to take it over.
Nice little break right there.
Yeah, extra yardage for this team to kind of help start.
Yeah, get the ball to 35. Potentially the last drive of the game.
It could be. We'll see. And, of course, for those of you who saw Evan England go down, he's not in this game right now. We're hoping he's okay. But for now, we've got Garrett Hutchinson, who has done a pretty decent job.
Oh, yeah.
In his shoes.
Mm-hmm. He's done what he needed to get done.
Hutchinson. He's going to find a man open in the middle of the field. Was it a catch? No. The officials are going to call it a no catch.
Yeah, that was close.
And that was intended for Ian Brocious.
Hutchinson's pass is incomplete. Intended receiver was Ian Brocious.
Let's take a look at the replay here in just a second. It's second and 10 on the 35. And... Yeah, it seemed like it touched the ground. Hutchinson's going to find another man open. Can he get out? He can. Brock Couch with the catch. Some fans looking for a flag there.
Yeah.
Either way, the clock is still moving.
Yeah, it's moving because he got knocked backwards.
Hutchinson finds Hayes. It is poked away. There's a flag on the play. This is a huge penalty late in the game.
Pass interference, potentially? Holding?
I wouldn't be shocked at either one. I think you can make a case for both.
If it's on the defense, you're on the other side of the field now. You get 15 of the pass interference, 10 of the holding call.
There's no indication. Both teams staying where they're at.
There's no penalty. It's pass interference.
Pick up the flag.
So let's take a look at this. I mean, it was swiped away. We did see a flag.
Fourth down.
So this is the game. Yeah. If you're a Duhok fan, this is the game.
Most important play of the game right here.
Fourth and one on the 35. For the Duhawks. And it is caught. It's taken out of bounds. It's a first down. It is complete to Brock Couch.
Yeah, you still have a minute left and a timeout. You're in good position here for the Duhawks. You're just about at midfield.
See if we can see some Hutchinson magic here. He's looking left. He sees Couch. It is overthrown.
Yeah, Couch has been targeted quite a bit today.
And for good reason. He has had quite the game so far. 65 yards, 7 receptions. Easy to think and have hope for the rest of this season and for the next couple years. And now you have found a fantastic receiver.
Yeah, he's a young guy, too. Has a lot to grow.
Hutchinson finds a man in the middle. Take it down. Is Brocious. The clock is still moving. You have time if you're the Duhok. Not a lot of it, but you've got enough time to try and get down.
The good thing here for the Duhok offense is they're used to this no-huddle, hurry-up offense.
Hutchinson, he looks right. He's going to try and find Hayes. It is a deep ball out.
Fourth down again.
Fourth down.
So it's fourth and four. And this could very well spell the game for the Duhawks. The Eagles sideline is loud. Hutchison looks, finds a man, and it's dropped by Hayes. And the Eagles are going to hold on.
You know, Duhok's battled back. They made this game interesting towards the end. It's still positive he made off this game.
And in a game where you thought it was going to go one way, it went another way. And just wait, the Duhawks couldn't close out. Let's take a look at this play. And it just bobbled in the hands of Jaheim Hayes. But well, and to your credit, and we talked about this game being so close before we went on air, and what a game, David. Unbelievable comeback, and it says a lot about this Duhok team and this character, and I know it's going to spell 0-2 in online in the stats book, and when you're going to come back next Saturday, you're going to play Buena Vista, but you're going to hold your head high and say, we came pretty darn close to this Eagles team.
Yeah, here's the thing. You still have 8 conference games left. This doesn't spell the end of the season.
Not at all.
You can still win your conference. You still have 8 conference games. You can end the year 8-2. This is a nice little tune-up game heading into conference play next week.
And so, 33 seconds left in this game, and there you can see it, the Eagles celebrating. What a game it has been. 27-22, and listen, the Eagles came in here, had a job to do, and they executed it. And it didn't go completely their way.
No.
But they gritted out the run game, and Blake Shoddy had this game all to him, it seemed like, for a large portion of this game. And Wojcicki did a great job too. Fantastic job handling the ball. There were a couple of spells in the second half where, you know, he could have been a little bit better, a little more poised, hold on to the ball. Yeah. But in the end, it didn't matter.
No. Yeah, Blake Shoddy, he had 26 carries for 171 yards and 2 touchdowns. You know, they did a good job stopping him in the second half. They did a good job playing well against the run. They played well.
So the Duhawks, they come back. They get to 22.
Mm-hmm.
And we welcome you back into the booth here, the closing moments of this game. 27-22, our final here once again at the Rock Bowl. David, what are some of your takeaways? What can this Duhawk team focus on,
you know,
before next week?
They're resilient. They can come out of that half and, play good football. What they need to focus on next week is limiting the turnovers. That's what hurt them in the beginning was those 3 turnovers early on. You had the 2 fumbles and the interception before half. Any of those go a different way, we're thinking about a different game here.
An exciting game here under the lights. Of course, not the results the Duhawks want, but some progress. You finally got scoring down, of course, after last week against Hope. So we're seeing progress made, and that's going to be, I think, a very big thing for Coach H when he talks to his team. Once again, our final here at the Rock Bowl, 27-22. David, thank you for joining me in the booth today. And as always, it's been a pleasure. We will see you later for covering games. Next week, once again, the Duhawks will come up and play here at the Rock Bowl against Buena Vista University. Our final score, 27-22. Thank you for watching. We'll see you later. Have a good night.